Either break into two groups and do it like that, or just do it all together. Doesn't matter to me. Just all together, alright. So you can just name off. And I do have these in a Word document too that I'll post to the course shell tonight, so that way you have all the questions and rationales behind them. Okay? Alright, so who wants to choose first? What is it? Which one? Cardiac 1 or 2? Cardiac 1? So a patient is diagnosed with heart failure and is prescribed digoxin and furosemide. Before administering the furosemide to the patient, which laboratory results should the healthcare provider review? Yep, serum potassium. Because what does a low potassium do to digoxin? Increases, becomes toxic, right? Okay, next one.
Lipid disease will happen.
400. The healthcare provider is teaching a patient diagnosed with hepatitis C about the disease. Which of these statements made by the patient indicate that the patient has an understanding of the teaching? Select all that apply. Acetaminophen is the best medication for me, so no, that won't be right.
It's
metabolism.
It
should be
ADF. Oh. Wouldn't it be too late to get?
I don't know.
Well, hepatitis A and B, they should just be prevented for anyways, so it's more or less just an education for them.
Oh,
it doesn't have anything.
I thought they had B.
Oh,
sorry,
no. Hepatitis B.
Yes.
SA, sorry. All right.
Let's see. Conflict 500.
So which of the following are stages of the conflict process?
Yeah, we did.
We did?
I thought it was B. No?
So interpersonal conflict is a type of conflict, whereas the conflict process goes through all of these stages.
I
yeah.
Swear to that existed.
Okay.
Addiction. 700.
The client is in end-stage liver failure from alcohol abuse. Which intervention should the nurse implement when addressing hepatic encephalopathy? Slide down and apply.
Monitor
the H&H, that's encephalopathy. H&H
will
be if they're bleeding.
Have you been monitoring the
monitoring the handwriting. Yeah, they can't replicate a drawing. Instructional apraxia.
PTSD 100.
During a post-traumatic stress disorder flashback, the patient states, "I feel like I'm going to die." The patient is hyperventilating, tachycardic, and reports feeling upper extremity numbness and tingling. Based on the patient's presentation, the healthcare provider would anticipate which additional clinical manifestation of the panic attack. Respiratory alkalosis, because then hyperventilating, they're going to be breathing fast, blowing off a lot of CO2.
Addiction for
100. Which of the following assessment findings in a patient's health history supports a diagnosis of substance dependence? Because if you have a dependence on something, when it's taken away, you're going to show withdrawal symptoms. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Cardia 2 for 500.
A patient has been diagnosed with chronic mitral regurge. When interviewing the patient, which of these should the healthcare provider expect the patient to report?
What is A for 500?
A.
Okay. You're saying it wrong.
Right, because think if there's blood regurgitating back up into the atrium, back up into the lungs, it's going to cause some left-sided symptoms.
Question.
Yeah.
The left side of the heart, that's what pumps out the blood, right?
Yes.
Okay.
How about cardiac 1-100?
Cardiac 1-100. The healthcare provider is performing an assessment on a patient who is taking propranolol for supraventricular tachycardia. Which assessment finding is an indication the patient is experiencing an adverse effect of this drug? Bradycardia. Yep. Which one?
Liver 800.
For a client with hepatic cirrhosis who has altered clotting mechanisms, which intervention would be most important?
B.
Applying pressure to injection sites. The nurse is a young unit manager of the pediatric ward. Most of his or her staff nurses are senior to him or her, very articulate, confident, and sometimes aggressive. The nurse feels uncomfortable believing that they are the scapegoat of everything that goes wrong in the department. Which of the following is the best action that he or she must take?
A.
A. So you want to identify the source of a conflict first. And then you can work from there.
Cardiac 1-500.
A nurse assessing a patient with heart failure would expect to find which of the following? B. Congestion of blood vessels. Yep. All the other things could lead to heart failure.
Addiction 300.
What one?
Addiction 300.
Addiction 300. A patient who has a history of chronic back pain requires a higher dose of an opioid medication in order to achieve adequate pain relief. The healthcare provider suspects that these findings are a result of which of the following?
D.
D. Tolerance. Yep.
PTSD 500.
A client diagnosed with PTSD is close to discharge. Which client statement would indicate that teaching about the psychosocial cause of post-traumatic stress disorder was effective? So you want them to be able to understand the experience, how they deal with it, and have a support group.
Liver
400. The patient is admitted to the medical unit with a diagnosis of hepatitis. When preparing to administer intravenous medications, the healthcare provider understands that the patient's diagnosis primarily impacts which phase of pharmacokinetics. D, metabolism, yep. Medications are metabolized in the liver.
Cardiac 2-700?
The patient has severe aortic stenosis. When assessing the patient, which of these findings would be expected? Narrowed pulse pressure. The healthcare provider is teaching a group of senior citizens about risk factors for heart failure. Which of these factors will the healthcare provider include in the teaching? Select all that apply. Is hypertension during pregnancy. Kind of a trick one. They all are. Obviously, this wouldn't be a test question, but I just wanted to test.
Well, when you put history of preeclampsia,
so,
it's a senior citizen.
Well, if they had preeclampsia when they were pregnant, that puts them at risk for developing hypertension later on in life.
Oh, right.
Yeah. Yeah. Next one.
Cardiac 2-1000.
Cardiac 2-1000. A child is admitted to the pediatric unit with a diagnosis of infective endocarditis. Which of the following interventions should the healthcare provider anticipate? Select all that apply.
CD.
They don't need seizure precautions.
Blood cultures.
So if someone has infective endocarditis, you want to do blood cultures to see what organism is growing. And then you give the antibiotics, and echo is going to look at the function of the heart. What one?
Liver 1000.
Liver 1000. for naloxone is prescribed for a client with chronic cirrhosis and ascites. The nurse should monitor the client for which of the following medication-related side effects? C, hyperkalemia, B, potassium sparing. A patient who had mitral valve replacement with a prosthetic mechanical valve is ready for discharge home. Which information should the healthcare provider include in the discharge teaching for this patient? Select all of the pie.
What is C? 900?
C.
So C?
Yeah.
What else?
D.
Oh,
yeah.
B
as well.
Oh, pregnant.
Because if someone is pregnant and they're on an anticoagulant, they'll need to be assessed for the risk of the fetus. So they may have to change anticoagulants.
And how long will
it last? It'll last upwards of 30 years at least.
Wow.
Mechanical.
Really?
Yeah.
What was it, B again?
Why was it B?
Yeah.
Because if a pregnant person were to get pregnant and they're on an anticoagulant, you want to make sure that that anticoagulant is not going to risk the fetus. So they may have to change anticoagulants sometimes.
What risk can it be to the fetus?
I don't know specifically if it puts them at higher risk for bleeding or what. It depends what they're on.
So cool.
Yeah.
Still in motion.
Cardiac 2-100.
A patient is being assessed for a possible heart failure. Which of these laboratory results provide support this diagnosis?
Mm-hmm.
My typing is wrong. What is it?
B.
D.
D.
BNP. The BNP will be elevated if someone is fluid overloaded.
More than 300. That is my.
LPSTD
600.
The nurse has received the evening report. Which client will the nurse need to assess first? That should say slept 2 to 3 hours.
Uh-oh.
So it's C.
What is C?
See, because there's a risk for them progressing even worse, so you want to take care of it before it gets worse. A new patient admitted with a history of panic attacks isn't currently having a panic attack, or not that it's telling us, so that's why.
And she keeps telling me, don't say that.
When planning the care of a client who has experienced PTSD, the nurse identifies which of the following as an appropriate goal. The client will report.
What is C for 400?
Yes, decreasing flashbacks and nightmares. Those are clinical manifestations of PTSD.
I learned my lesson.
After being robbed and beaten by an unknown assailant, a patient is diagnosed with PTSD. When developing a plan of care for the patient, which of these interventions will the healthcare provider plan implement first? So it's going to be C. Promote the establishment of a trusting relationship, because if you don't have a trusting relationship, you won't be able to really work with them further. A patient diagnosed with post-traumatic stress disorder is prescribed a benzodiazepine. When teaching the patient about this medication, which of the following information would the healthcare provider include? Sometimes patients can have the adverse effect of benzos where they actually become more restless and agitated by them. So if that happens, that's an adverse effect. cardiac one, 900. A patient who has a history of pulmonary valve stenosis tells the healthcare provider, I don't have a lot of energy anymore and both of my feet get swollen in the late afternoon. Which of these problems does the healthcare provider conclude is the likely cause of these clinical findings? D. Right heart failure. A patient diagnosed with mild heart failure is prescribed hydrochlorothiazide. The healthcare provider should determine the teaching about the medication has been successful if the patient makes which of these statements?
D.
Change position slowly.
Conflict 200.
As a young manager, the nurse knows that conflict occurs in any organization. Which of the following statements regarding conflict is not true?
B.
Remember back at that lecture, I had mentioned that you need some degree of conflict to maintain or like the organization to function. So some conflict is needed. Which one? For conflict? The nurse tells one of the staff, I don't have time to discuss the matter with you now. See me in my office later. When the latter asks if they can talk about an issue, which of the following conflict resolution strategies did he or she use?
Avoiding
it. Yep.
Kim, what does latter mean?
The other person.
Okay.
Yep.
Oh.
Which type of conflict occurs between two or more groups of people, departments, or organizations? Intergroup conflict.
600 conflict.
A charge nurse allows two nurses who are arguing about who gets to go to lunch first go together. The charge nurse agrees to take care of both of the nurses' clients during lunch. The charge nurse is demonstrating which of the following types of conflict management.
A.
Cooperating. A charge nurse has just finished giving a collaborative report to nurses on the unit for today's shift. One nurse who entered report late was pulled aside by the charge nurse who stated, when you are late, report is disrupted and I don't like having to repeat information that was already discussed. The charge nurse is using which style of communication? Assertive. So do you guys see all the components of the assertiveness in this? I know this is
like straight to the point.
It's to the point. It's stating the facts, their feelings, and it's using an I statement. They pulled the nurse aside so they didn't humiliate the nurse in front of all of the nurses during charge-to-charge report, right? And there's no exclamation or anything to insinuate that this nurse is yelling at this other nurse. Yes, no name calling, there's nothing that points to aggressiveness. What next?
Addiction 200.
Emergency medical personnel bring an unconscious patient to the emergency department. The patient's pupils are pupillate and respirations are depressed. Intoxication of which of the following substance could contribute to these clinical signs? The B, methadone. Because what is methadone? Okay.
Yay.
Good.
She said, what is it?
Which of the following goals would the healthcare provider identify as realistic for a patient with a substance abuse problem?
C.
Identifying trigger situations. A patient who overdosed on oxycodone is given naloxone. When assessing the patient, the healthcare provider would anticipate which of these clinical manifestations of opioid withdrawal. Irritability and nausea are signs and symptoms of opioid withdrawal. Sandra, a patient who is addicted to heroin begins a methadone maintenance program. Which of the following statements made by the healthcare provider correctly explains the rationale for treating this patient's substance abuse disorder with methadone? Select all that apply. Does not fall into that category. That's interviews with alcohol, yeah. All right, which one next?
Liver.
200. The patient is diagnosed with an infection caused by the hepatitis A virus. Which statement, if made by the patient, would indicate the patient needs further teaching about the infection? Get liver cancer someday because I have this infection. Hepatitis A does not lead to liver cancer. A member of the clinic housekeeping staff experiences a needle stick by a contaminated needle. Which of the following should be administered by the healthcare provider to provide the patient with passive immunity against the hepatitis B virus?
The
immunoglobulin. Yeah, good.
Okay.
Let's go down the line.
Yeah.
A patient diagnosed with hepatitis is undergoing a liver biopsy. When caring for the patient, which of these actions would be essential for the healthcare provider to take? Select all that apply. What do we think about A?
Yeah.
What about B?
No.
No. What about C?
No.
You don't. You don't care about liver function before a liver biopsy. It's more coagulation that you're looking at. What about D?
Yeah.
Yes.
What side your liver on?
Oh right. Oh no.
Oh.
So you're gonna be on
right.
Right. Ooh, that was a tricky
one.
Wow.
Yeah.
What about E?
Yeah.
And F,
yes.
I mentioned.
A-E-F.
A patient diagnosed with chronic hepatitis has developed hepatic encephalopathy. When assessing the patient, the healthcare provider looks for which of the following clinical manifestations characteristic of this condition. Select all that apply. The nurse is caring for a client with cirrhosis of the liver. The client has developed ascites and requires a paracentesis. Which of the following symptoms is associated with ascites and should be relieved by the paracentesis?
Mm-hmm.
atrophy. Remember, ascites is pushing up on the diaphragm, so it causes them to be dyspneic. The healthcare provider is reviewing health data collected on a group of patients at risk for high output heart failure. Which of the following problems increase a patient's risk for this disorder? Think of chronic anemia, the heart has to work harder to pump out all the blood to meet the needs of the body, right? Oxygen needs. Cirrhosis, you have an increase in circulating volume, so the heart's going to be pumping extra volume to the body. And hyperthyroidism, your basal metabolic rate is increased, so your heart's working harder to keep up with the basal metabolic rate. Healthcare provider is administering an angiotensin-converting enzyme or ACE inhibitor to a patient diagnosed with heart failure. Which of the following describe the ways in which ACE inhibitor is therapeutic for a patient with heart failure? Decreases the workload and decreases the preload because it's vasodilating, right? So the heart doesn't have to pump as hard or work as hard to push blood out into the circulatory system. Diagnosed with heart failure has been prescribed Digoxin. Which of the following will the healthcare provider include when teaching the patient about this medication? Select all of them.
So C.
So C. Yep.
B.
B.
What is the F?
So B, C, E, and F. Visual changes, that's toxicity. You're holding if pulse is less than 60.
I did.
Record a daily weight and call the office if you experience nausea or lack of appetite. Again, toxicity.
Doesn't count.
Cardiac one. A client develops left-sided heart failure after myocardial infarction. Which of the following would the nurse expect to find during the client assessment? Select all that apply.
A.
A. D.
Yes, what is A, D?
A, D, and E.
And C.
And C.
Yep. Or apnea, tachypnea, dyspnea,
and blood count.
Sputum, so all your respiratory symptoms.
Let's just say cardiac.
And on to the next one. Healthcare provider is caring for a patient with a diagnosis of mitral stenosis. When auscultating the patient's chest, which type of heart sound should the healthcare provider expect to hear? See, diastolic. Just think of where the mitral valve is, right? Opens during diastole. So if it's stenosed, you're going to hear it swoosh through during diastole.
Hip demand.
A patient with a history of coronary artery disease is being treated for AMI. During treatment, acute mitral valve regurg occurs. What is most likely the cause of acute mitral valve dysfunction?
D.
Yeah. Oh,
C. Rupture of the carotid tendineae.
What?
Because if the heart muscle is damaged, the carotid tendineae can weaken, and if they rupture, then the valve's not going to work appropriately.
The strings are holding the valve shut.
That's what it's called.
A 75-year-old patient will be undergoing a mitral valve replacement for severe mitral stenosis. When reviewing the patient's chart, which of these infectious diseases would likely be present in this patient's history?
What is B?
Yes. Rheumatic fever. Good. And the healthcare provider is caring for a patient with a systolic heart murmur. Which of these valve disorders are associated with systolic murmurs?
What is
C? Aortic stenosis, because it's open during systole, so when the blood tries to go through the stenosed valve, you can hear it. And mitral regurg, because that valve should be closed during systole, but it's backflowing. So you're going to hear the swoosh through the mitral valve. And the last one. A patient who has a diagnosis of mitral valve regurgitation is admitted to the hospital. Which of these findings indicate the patient is experiencing a serious complication from this valve disorder? Right, because if someone has regurg and the blood is kind of just sitting in that atrium and then it does get pushed through the left ventricle and out in the system, you're going to have stroke. So the hemiparesis and visual changes would be your serious complication, and dyspnea is expected with regurg. So I have some little bits of candy if you guys want some to pass around for play.
You got me.
And then otherwise we're all set.
Kim, is the finals pretty much going to be like that or easier?
Well, it can be tested on anything that you were taught this whole semester. This goes a little bit more in depth.
Okay.
But just
I know, like, this is like, it feels like this is like a year ago.
Anything we learned this semester.
Was that
this semester? Yeah.
Mind you, I gave up candy and became home right now. It's because of you and your dog.
So, Kim,
yeah,
for ethics,
like,
what would be your recommendation as far as like how to review it? Like more like definitions only? Okay.
I think pretty much
definitions
hard. Like if you understand the definitions, you understand them.
Okay.
So like all your principles and everything. Should be familiar with by now, so hopefully those are more of the easier ones for you.
Okay, thank you.
It was there, and I know I had to talk to her, but I wanted to.
because it had me left along the old one.